Good afternoon, Indy Nation. We're your anchors, Bella Gordon
and Nikki Alvarado. We hope you all had a great week.
This is your Independence News.
Are you ready? Ooh, I know you see me standing here. Do I look good, my dear? Do I look good today? Ooh, ooh, ooh. I'm just another kind of girl. And you wanna see my world. So come and run away. Yeah, yeah. If you wanna play, come and play today. Let's just get away. Yeah, I will make you see.
There will be a Power Monday next Monday, January 27th. School will begin at 8:25. Students, make sure you are on time.
The late bus runs Monday through Thursday at 5 p.m. It is for students who need to stay after school for credit recovery, tutoring, or ALEX. Make sure you sign up in student services before your eighth period.
Students, remember to bring your Chromebooks fully charged to school every day. If you forget, you can exchange your phone for a loaner Chromebook in the library and trade your phone back at the end of the day.
Mrs. Henderson's AP Environmental Science classes took a look at the world around us in their latest lab. Mac Hansen got us some more information.
What are you guys doing today?
We are looking at soil samples for AP Environmental Science, and we're checking things such as soil permeability and pH, and we're also looking at the amount of content of each type in the soil. So soil is made up of sand, clay, and silt, and we're looking at how much each sample from each different area shows in these samples.
So we are testing what's inside the dirt of our houses for like soil and stuff. And then we're testing the pH of it for some reason. So interesting.
Every time I look at you.
We're testing dirt, soil, for pH, what's in it, all the layers.
What you do, maybe we be so fine.
This has been Mac Hansen signing off for Independence News.
Students interested in taking AP Psychology, AP Gov and Econ, or History of Ideas need to stop by rooms D124, D123, or D127 to pick up a recommendation form. All forms are due back by Friday, January 24th.
All students who participated in the PSAT, please pick up your score printout and test booklet from the counseling office.
The Youth and Government Club will be selling donuts during the next Power Monday. Make sure you bring some cash if you're interested.
Jesse and Aaron are back with some new information in arts. Let's check it out.
I'm Jesse Banalis.
And I'm Aaron Thompson.
And welcome back to this week's arts. The Theater 4 play Trap will be next Wednesday, the 29th, at 7. Let's take a look on how they're preparing.
Theater 4 is putting on a show called Trap. It is a high school play about a high school play, and we've been working on it for about 2 months now. We have done everything from the set to the costumes to learning all of the different parts, and it's all student-led. So we've been doing it in class, and we've met up outside of class a couple times, and we're really excited with the product that we have. And the show date is going to be next Wednesday, January 29th.
I'm Norma Pike.
I'm Brian Gerbani.
I'm Rick Enoch Banner.
I'm Candelario.
I'm Marianne. I'm Detective Hage.
And I tell you a secret.
Congratulations to Mackenzie Owens, Amy Chalky, Gabe Tiemann, and Logan Bach for winning gold keys for their digital art and design work.
That's it for this week.
See you next time.
Bank of America is pleased to share that the 2020 Bank of America Student Leaders application is now open for current juniors and seniors. Here in Nashville, student leaders are awarded an 8-week paid summer internship with Oasis Center and participate in an all-expense paid National Leadership Summit in Washington, D.C. The application is open through January 31st. Talk to your counselor for some more information.
The state has issued a new type of diploma distinction, the Seal of Biliteracy. This recognizes students who have attained a high-level proficiency in speaking, reading, and writing in more than one language. If you are interested, talk to your world language teacher.
Ellie and Ashley came to you with a very controversial question this week.
Personally, I'm very passionate about this issue.
Let's see what you all had to say on this week's Wheel of Indy.
What's up, Indy Nation? We're back with week 17 of Wheel of Indy.
Let's go spin the wheel to see what the category is.
Okay, do you think mullets should make a comeback?
Absolutely.
But only certain people. Because like some people, oh.
No, no, not at all.
Why?
Because that's like 1860s. I don't, like, that's why I cut my hair. Because I was getting close to a mullet, like a black person mullet. And black people mullets don't look good.
Okay.
So that's why I would say no.
Yes.
Absolutely not.
Why?
They're ugly.
I think they're really cool.
They're straight ugly. No, please don't get one.
I wanted to get one, but my mom said no, so.
Shaved on the side looks so
no,
bad.
I like it.
No, I like it.
I mean, Griffin says so.
No.
Why?
I just don't think they look good. Okay, they look good on certain people, just not everyone.
That's a funny question. No.
Why?
Because they're gross. Literally, that's so gross. Thank you.
If I saw somebody with a mullet, I would bring my own clippers and cut it off. Because that would look terrible.
I mean, Griffin rocks it, so.
They are ugly. Only a very few amount of people can actually wear mullets.
Yeah.
Okay, why?
Because I think men should be empowered to do what they want with their hair. And I think mullets are a statement.
Okay, yeah. That's it for this week.
Seniors and early graduates, don't forget to submit your college offers to your counselor throughout the year, including the offers you choose not to accept.
The Youth and Government Club meets every Wednesday morning in Mr. Ragland's room. You can find his room in the new wing if you are interested.
Indy Interact is a club here at Independence working to serve our local community. This week, we took a closer look into their latest meeting.
My name's Olivia Kahn. I'm the president of Independence Interact Club, which is a club that kind of goes off of the Rotary. Right now, we're packaging cookies for the nursing home, which we're going to go deliver on Sunday.
Every other Thursday, we meet in Ms. Leonard's room after school, and anyone is welcome to come.
Seniors, the volunteerism diploma will be awarded to students who complete and log more than 10 volunteer hours per semester. You can stop by the counseling office to submit and track your hours if you are interested.
ACT testing dates are coming up. To view the various dates and locations, log into your ACT account and register at act.org.
Packets for track tryouts are outside of Coach Harden's room, B217. All athletes must be entered in final forms and have a current physical to try out.
Now, let's get into this week's sports.
What's up, Indy Nation? Welcome back to Indy Sports.
It's week 17. Let's do it. Our boys swim team won their division this year. Good job, boys. Regionals is today. Be there and support them.
Our wrestling team wrestled against Page on Tuesday, and yesterday they wrestled against Spring Hill, which was their senior night.
This Tuesday, our boys and girls basketball teams both beat Ravenwood. Good job, boys and girls. Today, it's at Page. Be there and support them. That's all for this week, Indy Nation.
Come back next week for week 18.
Thanks for tuning in to this week's News Independence.
We hope you have a great weekend, and as always,
we'll see you next Friday.